Hello students, hope you are all safe at home. So let us start our online classes through YouTube to bridge the gap in your education system. So let's start with the lesson 1, force. So in force, we'll start with the first topic, moment of force. Before going into the topic, let's know what is a rigid body and non-rigid body. Rigid body and non-rigid body. A rigid body is a body which does not deform. It means it does not change its shape and size. It does not change its shape and size by the action of force. So those bodies which does not change the shape and size by the action of force, it means they does not deform, is called a rigid body. And coming to the non-rigid body, a body which can change its shape and size by the action of force. So by the action of force, it can change its shape and size. Such bodies are called as non-rigid bodies. So let us take some example of a rigid body. A stone, by applying number of forces, we cannot change its shape or size. And here, for non-rigid body, let us take an example of sponge. By the action of force, we can change its shape and size. So this is what about rigid and non-rigid body. So a rigid body does not change its shape. It does not deform by the action of number of forces. A non-rigid body will be deformed by the action of forces. So now let us see about what is point of action of force. Point of action of force. So this is a point where we are applying the force on a rigid body. Suppose here is a rigid body which we cannot change its shape or size by the application of force. So here I am giving some force at a particular point. So this point where I am applying the force on the rigid body is called point of action of force. So this is the point of action of force. Next one is line of action of force. What is this line of action of force? So this is an imaginary line drawn at the point of action of force. Imaginary line drawn along the point of action of force is called the line of action of force. So point of action of force is the point where the force is applied. And line of action of force is an imaginary line drawn along the point of action of force. Now I am applying some force on the rigid body. By applying the force, the rigid body will be undergoing two types of motions. One is linear motion and the other one is rotatory motion. When it will undergo the linear motion, when I have given some force, If the body is free, then it will take the linear motion, or we will also call it as translatory motion. So the body will undergo a linear motion or translatory motion when it was free to move. If the body is pivoted to a point, it means now I have pivoted this one, I have fixed to a point. When it is pivoted to a point and I have given some force for the rigid body, then it will start moving in a circular path or the rotatory motion. So the rigid body, on the application of force, it can undergo a linear motion or the rotatory motion. Linear motion when the body is free and rotatory motion when the body is pivoted to a point. Now we will move deep into the subject. Let us start moment of force. So what is this moment of force? Moment of force, or we also call it as torque. Torque. So it is the product of force into perpendicular distance. Product of force and perpendicular distance. Moment of force is nothing but the turning effect. Suppose there is a door. I want to open it. So to open a door, here is a door. rotation. This is the point of rotation, as we are calling. This is the point about which the body is rotating, is called point of rotation. With respect to this point, the body is rotating. So this is called as point of rotation. Now the door is moving with respect to this axis. So this is called as axis of rotation. Axis of rotation. So now I can open the door with respect to this line. Is called axis of rotation. Now the door is turning. I am opening the door. So to open the door, I have to apply some force. So I am applying the force over here. Is it clear? So what is this perpendicular distance? Perpendicular distance is the distance between the axis of rotation and the point of application of force. Perpendicular distance is the distance between point of rotation or axis of rotation. So it may be the point of rotation or axis of rotation. And so the distance between this one is the perpendicular distance. The distance between axis of rotation and the point of application of force, where you are applying your force. So that particular distance is called the perpendicular distance between the point of application of force and the axis of and point of rotation. So this moment of force is a force into perpendicular distance, or turning effect is nothing but a product of force and perpendicular distance between the point of application of force and point of rotation. This is the perpendicular distance. Now let us see moment of force. So moment of force is the product of force and perpendicular distance. This perpendicular distance is the distance between the point of application of force and the point of rotation. Now let me give you one example. There is a rod which was fixed to a point. I have fixed here, fixed point. Now I am applying a force. When it is pivoted to a point by the application of force, now it starts rotating. So this rotation might be anti-clockwise direction, or if I was pivoted to a point here and applying the force in this direction, then it will be in clockwise direction. So by the application of force, when the body is pivoted to a point, it can take anti-clockwise direction or clockwise direction. So this is called anti-clockwise movement, and this one is called clockwise movement. Always anti-clockwise movement is taken as positive and clockwise movement is considered as negative. Anti-clockwise movement is always taken as positive. This will be helpful when we are doing the numericals. And clockwise movement is considered as negative charge. Now, this moment of force is affected by two factors. If I want to increase this moment of force, I can increase the force or the perpendicular distance. More is the force, more will be the moment of force. Or one more factor, more is the perpendicular distance, more will be the moment of force. In previous question papers of ICSE, they have asked what are the factors affecting the moment of force. So there are two factors which are affecting the moment of force. One is the more the force, more will be the moment of force. And the other one, more the perpendicular distance, more will be the moment of force. Now let us talk about the units of this moment of force. So what is the formula for moment of force? Force into perpendicular distance. Units of force is newton, and perpendicular distance, units of perpendicular distance is meter in SI system. So what are the units of moment of force now? It is newton meter in SI system. Now if you want these units to convert into CGS system, 1 newton is equal to 10 to the power of 5 dynes, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters, nothing but 10 to the power of 2 centimeters. So now let us substitute these values here, 1 newton meter. So 10 to the power of 5 dynes into 10 to the power of 2 centimeter. So this is equal to 10 to the power of 7
9 centimeter. So 1 newton meter is equal to 10 to the power of 7 9 centimeter. So this is also one of the previous question in the ICSE board question papers. What is the relation between SI and CGS units of moment of force? So this is the relation. 1 newton meter is equal to 10 to the power of 7 9 centimeter. Now let us see some of the examples. Suppose spanner is having a long handle. Now I have to open this wrench nut. I am using this wrench to open this nut. So they ask you the jack screw, not only the spanner, many examples like jack screw. It was there in 2017. Why the jack screw is having the long handle, or why the spanner is having the long handle? This is the point of application of force, the point where we are applying the force, and this is the perpendicular distance, turning point and point of application of force. This is your turning point and we are applying the force, and this will be the perpendicular distance. So to increase the moment of force, the turning effect, I have to increase either force or the perpendicular distance. So now we have increased the perpendicular distance by increasing its arm. So longer arm will show you the more perpendicular distance. More the perpendicular distance, more will be the moment of force. And the force what we have to apply, the effort we are applying will be less when perpendicular distance is more. So more the perpendicular distance, less will be the moment of force. What less will be the force what we are applying. So now let us see some numericals related to this one. So now we have a force, we are applying a force of 5 newtons to open a nut using a spanner which is having a perpendicular distance of 2 meters. So your force is 5 newton and your perpendicular distance is 2 meters. What is the moment of force? Simple formula. Moment of force is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Before substituting the values, check whether both the given values are in the same units or not, same system. Now here it is in newton and meter, both are in SI system, so you can go ahead by substituting. If they are not in SI system, suppose they have given it in centimeters, then you have to convert from centimeters to meters. Already we know the relation. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So using this, we will convert back into the same system. Now both are in SI system, no need of any conversion. Let us simply directly substitute them, 5 newton into 2 meter. So it is 10 newton meter. So your moment of force is 10 newton meter. And there is one more type of numerical related to moment of force. Suppose there is a rigid bar which is, or rigid bar of, or they will be telling that a meter scale or half meter rule. In 2018 we have a question in a meter rule, half meter rule. Half means 0 to 50 centimeters. If it is a meter rule, it will be 0 to 100 centimeters. Now let me tell you that question, what is given in 2018. A half meter rod is pivoted at the center. It was pivoted at the center, fixed at the center. Center of half meter rule will be 25 centimeters. We know that. Two weights, 20 GF and 12 GF. Two weights are there, one is 20 GF and the other one is 12 GF, suspended at a distance of 6 centimeters and 10 centimeters from the pivot. One is 20 and the other one is 12. And one is at a distance of 6 centimeters, what they have given, and the other one is at a distance of 10 centimeters from the pivoted point. Now what they are asking. A half meter rod is pivoted at the center with two weights, 20 GF and 12 GF, suspended at a perpendicular distance of 6 centimeters and 10 centimeters from the pivoted point respectively. as shown below. They have given this diagram also in 2019. Now, the question they are asking, which of the two forces acting on the rigid body causes clockwise movement? So, because of this 20 GF, we will get anti-clockwise movement because it is pulling down. So, this meter rule will be moving anti-clockwise direction. And 12 GF will be moving clockwise direction. So, your first question is, what is the force acting clockwise? So, 12 GF is your answer. A force of 12 GF makes the half meter rod to rotate in clockwise direction. Second question, is the meter rod in equilibrium? Now let us check, what is the moment of force anti-clockwise direction and moment of force clockwise direction? So moment of force in anti-clockwise direction is equal to force into perpendicular distance. What is the force here? 20. What is the perpendicular distance? 6. So 120 newton. GF centimeter. Units are different. GF centimeter. So this is the moment of force due to anti-clockwise direction. Now let us see what is the moment of force due to clockwise direction. Moment of force in clockwise direction is equal to force into perpendicular distance. So clockwise direction, what is your force? 12 GF into what is your perpendicular distance? 10 centimeter. So it is also 120 GF centimeter. Both the clockwise and anti-clockwise moment of force are same. Therefore, the meter rod is in equilibrium. So your second question is, they are asking you to check whether this meter or half meter rod is in equilibrium or not. Both are same. It means the meter rod is in equilibrium. Third question. The direction of 20 GF is reversed. Now they are telling, it was in this direction till now. Now the direction is reversed. Means it was also moving in clockwise direction. Now not this one. It was also going in clockwise direction. So what we should do? If it was in the clockwise direction, we will add these two. Because moment of force due to this one and moment of force due to this. Moment of force due to 20 GF is equal to force into perpendicular distance, that is equal to 20 into 6 plus moment of force due to 12 GF means 12 into 10 centimeters. That is equal to 120 plus 120, 240 GF centimeter. So when both are acting in the same direction, this meter rod will rotate. The turning effect of meter rod is 240 GF centimeter in clockwise direction because both are in clockwise direction. We change the direction of 20 GF. So this is the model what they have asked in 2018. Even in 2020 they asked you from this part, define moment of force. Define moment of force. It is the product of force and perpendicular distance between the point of application of force and the point of rotation. Or you can also tell that it is the turning effect of the applied force of a body about the turning point or axis of rotation.